How do you instantly detect and indicate which player presses their button first? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make the fastest finger first circuit using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 27 jumper wires, 4 10,000 ohms resistor, 2 1,000 ohms resistor, 5 270 ohm resistor, 4 1N4148 fast switching diodes, 5 LEDs, 5 momentary push button switches, 4 555 timer IC, a battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and a stable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, a stable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. A breadboard has positive and negative rails on the left side and positive and negative rails on the right side. In this circuit, the left positive rail serves as the status rail, while the right negative rail serves as the reset rail. I'll explain in more detail why these rails are needed in the second part of this video. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Insert a momentary push button switch one row above the 555 timer. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 1 or ground to pin 6 or threshold. Insert a jumper wire into pin 2 or trigger in one leg of the switch. Insert a jumper wire into the status rail and one leg of the switch. Insert a jumper wire into pin 4 or reset and the reset rail. Insert one leg of the LED into pin 3 or output, and the other leg into a row just below the 555 timer. The longer leg is in pin 3. Bend the ends of the diode. Insert the 1N4148 diode into the status rail and pin 3 or output. The anode is in pin 3. Bend the ends of a 470 ohm resistor. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into the negative rail and the same row as the leg of the LED that is below the 555. Bend the ends of a 10,000 ohm resistor. Insert the 10,000 ohm resistor into one leg of the switch and the positive rail. Let's continue with the second set of 555 timers. Insert a switch 5 rows below the 555 timer. Insert a 555 2 rows below the switch. Insert a jumper wire into the negative rail and pin 1 or ground. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 or VCC and the positive rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 1 or ground to pin 6 or threshold. Insert a jumper wire into pin 4 or reset and the reset rail. Insert a jumper wire into the status rail and one leg of the switch. Insert a jumper wire into one leg of the switch and pin 2 or trigger. Insert one leg of the LED into pin 3 or output and the other leg into a row just below the 555 timer. Insert the one N4148 diode into the status rail and pin 3 or output. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into the negative rail and the same row as the leg of the LED that is below the 555. Let's continue with the third 555 timer. Ensure that each wire is connected to the correct rail when setting up the circuit. Although there are two positive and two negative rails, one positive rail functions as the status rail, and one negative rail is designated as the reset rail. If you plug the wire into the wrong rail, the circuit won't work. Let's continue with the fourth 555 timer. Insert an LED a few rows below the fourth 555 timer. The longer leg is closer to the 555. Insert a switch in the middle of the breadboard and two rows below the LED. Insert a jumper wire in the status rail and the same row as the longer leg of the LED. Insert a jumper wire in the negative rail and one of the legs of the switch. Insert a jumper wire in one of the legs of the switch and the reset rail. Bend the ends of a 470 ohm resistor. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into the negative rail and the same row as the shorter leg of the LED. Bend the ends of a 1000 ohm resistor. Insert the 1000 ohm resistor into the positive rail and the reset rail. Bend the ends of a 1000 ohm resistor. Insert the 1000 ohm resistor into the status rail and the negative rail. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. This circuit detects which contestant presses their button first during a quiz, game show, or competition. At the beginning, all the LEDs light up. Press the reset button to turn off all the LEDs. When multiple players try to answer at once, only the first button press is recognized. It lights up that player's LED and blocks all others from triggering their LEDs. To start a new round, the reset button has to be pressed. Let's see it again. All the players line up to press their button. The LED lights up when the first button is pressed. After this happens, all the other buttons are blocked from turning on their LEDs. Pressing the reset button is needed to clear the system and start a new round. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This circuit is a fastest finger first game using 4555 timer ICs configured in monostable mode. It allows players to compete by pressing a button, and the first one to press lights up their corresponding LED while locking out the others. The circuit has four rails: the reset rail, the positive rail, the negative rail, and the status rail. Each 555 timer is connected to its own push button and LED. In each setup, pin 8 or VCC is connected to the positive rail. pin 1 or ground to the negative rail, and pin 4 or reset to the reset rail, which is normally high. Pin 6 or threshold and pin 2 or trigger are tied together and connected to a push button, while a 10,000 ohms resistor ensures that the trigger pin stays high when the button isn't pressed. When a player presses their button, it momentarily pulls the trigger pin low, causing the 555 timer to output a high signal at pin 3 or output. The first player to press their button will trigger their 555 timer, turning their LED on through a 270 ohm resistor. At the same time, their 555 output also pulls the status rail high. This high signal blocks the other timers from triggering even if other players press their buttons afterward, effectively locking out late presses. There is also a reset button connected to the reset rail. Pressing it pulls the reset rail low, which resets all the 555 timers by disabling their outputs and turning off all the LEDs, preparing the circuit for the next round. On the far right of the circuit, a red LED indicator is connected through a resistor network to show that the system has been locked and a player has won. I hope this video has shown you how to make the fastest finger-first circuit with a 555 timer. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.